Hello students, I welcome all of you for fifth lecture on current electricity. In the previous lecture we have calculated the equivalent resistance for series and parallel combination, and we have also seen in case of series combination the voltage applied across the branch gets divided along the different resistance. Now suppose if the voltage difference from A to B is V, then this V will get divided in V1, V2 and V3, and the division of voltage was proportional with the resistance. We have discussed this concept. Now for parallel combination, if the current given to this combination of resistance, then for parallel combination what happens, the current gets divided along the parallel branches, and what happens, the current provided by the battery will be the summation of current going into each branch, I1 plus I2 plus I3, and we have also seen that the current given to these branches is in inverse proportion with the resistance of that particular branch. So from these two concepts, suppose a circuit is given to us which has resistances R1 equal to 2 ohm, R2 equals to 3 ohm, R3 equals to 4 ohm. For this value of resistance in this circuit, if the question is what is the ratio of voltage drop across these resistances, so we know that the voltage in series is divided in proportion with the resistance, so I will write the answer 2:3:4. This is the answer. But for same resistance, if someone asks what is the ratio of current, then we know that the current gets divided in inverse proportion of the resistance, then the answer will be 1:2, 1:3, 1:4. Now here you can arrange this by taking LCM, that is the next step, and that arrangement will be actually depending on what the options given in the question. Now I would like to discuss few questions for the calculation of equivalent resistance. This is a network given to us. We have to calculate the equivalent resistance across A and B. Now if we see, all these three resistances are in parallel. So to calculate the equivalent resistance across AB, for parallel branch we know that the equivalent resistance inverse is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. From here it will be 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. This is 3 by 4. Hence R equivalent will be 4 by 3 ohm. Answer 4 by 3 ohm. Now next circuit I am taking here, very basic circuit. Initially I will discuss the questions like this. Suppose these two are the terminals AB, this is 2 ohm, this is 3 ohm and this one is 6 ohm. So now we have to calculate the equivalent resistance across AB. So it can be redrawn as this 2 ohm and the equivalent resistance of these two. If you see, for two parallel elements the equivalent resistance is 3 × 6 upon 3 + 6. This is what? 18/9, that is 2 ohm, this is 2 ohm. So equivalent resistance across AB is 2 + 2, that is 4 ohm. Now see the next question. In the next question, third one, the equivalent resistance need to be calculated. This is 10 ohm, this is 2 ohm, 4 ohm. I am taking here one more resistance, 3 ohm, and then I will take 4 ohm. Question is like this. Now we have to calculate the equivalent resistance for A to B. Now what to do? We will see the branches which are in series and in parallel, and then we will eliminate those branches. Like I am redrawing, you will redraw in your notebook. 2 and 4 are in series, so will be directly added. This is 6 ohm. This 6 ohm and 3 ohm are in parallel. 6 parallel with 3 will be equal to 6 into 3 by 6 plus 3. So it is 2 ohm. So I will replace this with 2 ohm. Now this 2 ohm and 10 ohm are in series. So I will add directly. This resistance will become 12 ohm. Now see, A and B are in parallel. Two resistances are in parallel. R1 into R2 upon R1 plus R2 will be the equivalent resistance. 12 into 4 by 12 plus 4. This is 12 into 4 by 16. 4 times 3. So the equivalent resistance we will get is 3 ohm. Now see the next question. Question number 4. For this question, the circuit is shown like this. You see here. Resistances are connected in this way. Now, one more resistance here. This terminal is A, this is B, and the resistances I am taking 4, 2, 2, 6, 2, 6, and 2. Now we have to calculate the equivalent resistance for this circuit across A and B. See, first we check the resistances in parallel and series in direct form. If you see, the 4 and 2 ohm resistances are here in series. I will simply add these two and will equate with 6 ohm. Now see, here this terminal is actually sorted with this terminal, and this terminal is sorted with this terminal. So if you see, after this point, the circuit is like this. So what happens, whenever a short circuit comes, means it has short circuit has resistance 0 ohm, I have already defined. This 0 ohm resistance being in parallel with any other resistance will make the resistances unuseful. So we see direct 0 ohm is getting connected from this point to this point. We will also eliminate this resistance. So the circuit will be like this. The equivalent resistance will be 6 ohm answer. Now see the next question. Question number 6. Resistance combination is shown like this. This is A, this is B. And the resistances they have given, suppose 1, 1, 1 ohm. Now we have to calculate the equivalent resistance of A, B. So what we need to do here, whenever we have a very different combinations, we will not be directly able to distinguish whether they are in series or parallel. Then we will start searching for the point which are having at similar potential. So if this is A even and this terminal is B, so you see this is directly a wire. This terminal will also be B. This is also B. This is also B. So for each resistance, one terminal is at A, another terminal is at B. So if I redraw then these three resistance are coming in parallel, well, 1 1. So 1 by R will be equal to 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1. This is 3. Hence, equivalent resistance across AB will be 1 by 3. Okay. Now, if I change this question like this, taking one more resistance, 7th question here, and the terminal A is this one. Now what will be the resistance, equivalent resistance? Now you see, for each resistance, one terminal is at A, another terminal is at B, because this is a shorted wire. For shorted wire, the potentials of each and every point is same. So if we see from point potential point of view, then we will find the four resistances are there connected in parallel. 1 1 1 1. So equivalent resistance 1 by R equivalent is 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1. This is equivalent to 4. So equivalent resistance will be 1 by 4 ohm. See the next question. 3 ohm, 3 ohm, 3 ohm are connected like this. So we will not be directly able to find that these resistances are connected in series or in parallel. So I will do what? I will try to search the point which is at common potential. So if this is point A, then it is sorted with this point, this will also be point A. If this is point B, then it is sorted with point B here. Now, if you see this resistance, it has one terminal at A, another at B. For this resistance, one is at A, another is at B. For this resistance, same, one terminal is at A, another terminal is at B. So this is a combination of three resistance in parallel. This question has been asked in many exams and still they are asking this combination. So whenever you find a combination like this, these two points are sorted with each other, then you write all these resistances in parallel. 1 by RAB is 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3, which is 1. Hence, equivalent resistance across AB is 1 ohm answer. Now, see the next question. We have a combination of resistance like this. I will take this bit here. 2 ohm, then 1, 2, point A, this is terminal B. Again, we have to calculate the equivalent resistance across A and B. So, I will try to find the resistances which are directly in series or in parallel. So, you see 1 and 1 are in series. I will replace this with 1 plus 1, 2 ohm. Now, this 2 ohm and 2 ohm are in parallel. For parallel, 2 into 2 by 2 plus 2, this is equal to 1. So I will replace these two by a 1 ohm resistance. Again, 1 and 1 are in series. So this one will become 2. 2 and 2 are in parallel. This one will get changed to 1 ohm. 1 ohm, 1 ohm in series. So it is changed into 2 ohm. Now 2 ohm and 2 ohm are in parallel. So equivalent resistance across AB is 2 into 2 by 2 plus 2, which is 1 ohm answer. Now see the next question. Question number 10. One resistance 2 ohm, another resistance here 12, 4, one more combination here. 12 ohm, this is 4 ohm, this is 2 ohm, and these 3 are equal, 15, 15, 15. So we have to calculate again the equivalent resistance across A and B. If you see these, then the 1 by R equivalent will be 1 by 15 plus 1 by 15 plus 1 by 15. This is 3 by 15, 1 by 5. So R is 5 ohm. I will replace this by a 5 ohm resistance. For this one, 12 into 4 by 12 plus 4, this is 3. So I will replace this section by 3 ohm. So the answer directly can be written AB 2 plus 3 plus 5, this is a 10 ohm equivalent resistance. Now see the next and very important, already asked in J. The question is, the total resistance of a wire is 20 ohm. Now the wire is bent to form a pentagon. Pentagon is formed like this. And two terminals are taken out. One is A, another is B. Now they have asked the equivalent resistance across AB. This question is asked recently in J mains. Now this 20 ohm resistance is wire is drawn in the form of a regular pentagon. Regular means what? Regular pentagon means what? The size of all the sides will be same. It means all the branches will have equal resistances. So the 20 ohm is divided in 5 equal part. So 4 ohm each will be there. If you see, these 4 resistances are in series with each other. So this one will be replaced with a resistance of 16 ohm. So for equivalent resistance, this 16 and 4 are in parallel. So the answer will be 3.2 ohm. Next, we will see a very famous network called Wheatstone Bridge. In this network, actually, we have 4 resistances connected in this way. This arm AB and BC is called ratio arm, connected with fixed resistance P and Q. The arm CD is called a variable arm, where it is connected with a resistance R which can be varied. And fourth arm DA is called unknown arm, where we connect the resistance whose value is not known to us. And one more device you see here, G, which is called galvanometer. It is used to find the direction of flow of current. Galvanometer should be known in detail, and we will study about the galvanometer at the end of this chapter. Right now we should know that galvanometer shows only the deflection of current, whether it is from left to right or from right to left. But if there is no current through the galvanometer, then we call it is the null deflection condition for the galvanometer. Means the pointer of galvanometer will point to its zero. So starting with the analysis of this circuit, what happens? There is a very important condition of this circuit. We connect unknown value of resistance in this arm, and we keep varying the value of resistance in this variable arm. We achieve a situation where the current through the galvanometer becomes zero. When the current through the galvanometer becomes zero, you can see here that the potential at B and the potential at D will also become equal. As we have connected this circuit with a voltage source V, so what will happen if I consider this point at potential V then the point C will be considered at point 0. And if VB equals to VD, I consider as X. It means the potential at B is X and the potential of D will also be X. Now you see, if no current is going into the galvanometer, so what will happen? Whatever current is going into the P, suppose I1, will be flown through the Q also. Similarly, the current I2, if I consider going into S, will be flown through R also, because in this branch there is no flow of current. So what should be the next step? Making the potential of B and potential of D equal, there is no flow of current through the galvanometer, and this condition is called the condition of balanced Wheatstone bridge. This is a very, very important condition. When we keep varying this variable resistance, then the situation where the galvanometer current becomes zero, at that condition the bridge is called a balanced bridge. In the case of balanced bridge, what is happening? The potential of B is equal to potential of D, which is equal to X. Now, if you see, the potential at A is V and potential at B is X. So what is the value of VA minus VB? The VA minus VB is written as I1 into P. This is equation number 1. And what is VB minus VC? It is equal to, again, same I1 current will flow through Q. So it is I1 into Q. Equation number 2. Now, if I consider the potential at B as X, then the equation number 1 can be written as, this relation can be written as V minus X equal to I1 into P. And the second equation is written as X minus 0 equal to I1 into Q. This set of equation I consider the relation A. Now the next, if we see the bottom bridge, then we will have VA minus VD equal to I2 into S, and VD minus VC equal to I2 into R. Now again, if I write, since we have considered VD as the potential of X and VC as 0 volt, then the second set of equation will be like VA means V minus X will be equals to I2 into S, and X minus 0 equal to I2 into R. This is the second set of equation. Now if we equate these equations, then I1 into P will be equal to I2 into S, and I1 into Q will be equal to I2 into R. So making these things equal, I1 into P making equal to I2 into S, the ratio of current I1 is to I2 will be S upon P. Next, I1 into Q equals to I2 into R, then the ratio of current will be R upon S. This is the relation number second I consider. Now, since I1 is to I2 will be equal, so equating these two relation 1 and 2, making equal, then S by P will be equal to, actually this is R by Q. S by P will be equal to R by Q. So the unknown resistance S can be calculated as P by Q into R. So we see we are able to find the value of unknown resistance of such kind of circuit. But remember, This is the condition only valid in case of balanced Wheatstone bridge. Means once the bridge is balanced, then we say that the galvanometer is getting zero current. So when this galvanometer is getting zero current, whatever is connected here, suppose instead of galvanometer, if someone connects a resistance, and if the condition of balanced bridge is satisfied here, then this resistance, whatever R prime I am taking, will be eliminated, and we can easily solve the circuit. So if I summarize the Wheatstone bridge, the bridge will be balanced when this branch will not get any current. And the condition for balanced bridge is P into R equals to Q into S. In other words, we can say if the circuit satisfies this condition P into R equals to Q into S, then the current through this resistance, which I have taken here as the load resistance, will be equal to zero. And once the current in any branch is equal to zero, we can eliminate this resistance from the circuit. Now, one very important conclusion we need to draw from this circuit, which is like, if I interchange this battery and the load resistance, means if the load resistance is connected here and the battery is connected at this point, then if the bridge is balanced previously, if the P into R equal to Q into S, then by interchanging the position of load and battery, still the bridge is a balanced bridge. Okay, so when we interchange load and voltage for a balanced bridge, then after interchanging these two, the bridge will remain balanced. Let's continue with the questions for calculating the equivalent resistance. Now for this circuit, calculate the equivalent resistance across A and B. So it looks like a Wheatstone bridge. Now we have to check whether it is balanced or not. If you see 2 into 4 and 2 into 4, these two are equal. It means the bridge is balanced. For a balanced bridge, current do not go in this branch. So we can eliminate this branch to calculate the equivalent resistance across A and B. So if you see, directly 2 and 4 ohm will come in series and the value will be 6 ohm. Here also the bottom bridge will have equivalent resistance of 6 ohm. Now these two, 6 ohm and 6 ohm, are in parallel. So equivalent resistance of AB will be 6 into 6 divided by 6 plus 6. You can find the answer as 3 ohm. So this is the way to calculate the equivalent resistance for a balanced bridge condition. Next question: if we have a circuit like this and we have to calculate again the equivalent resistance across A and B, suppose all the resistance are of value R. Now again, for the unknown structure, what we are going to do? We will try to search the point which is having at same potential. Now, if you see, this is point A. So this is not getting connected directly with any other point. So I will have to name this as C, this as D, and then B. So all the node means what? Principal node. Principal node means more than two branches are coming from this point, or from this junction. So I will reconstruct this circuit by considering A here and B at this point. From A to C, if I take C here, then from A to C there is a resistance, this one, and C to D there is a resistance. I am just redrawing the circuit given, and D to B there is a resistance here. Now from B to C this resistance, and from D to A this resistance. So we have redrawn this circuit. Now for the given value of resistance, I will check whether the circuit is balanced with Stone or not. If you see, R into R will be equal to R into R. It means it is a balanced bridge condition. So the circuit will get calculated as these two above bridge resistances will be in series. So 2R and 2R in series. So we will get the answer of equivalent resistance as R, because 2R, 2R in parallel, it will be calculated to R. Now see the next question. This is a very, very important question. It is a Wheatstone bridge, but it is not a balanced one. Because if you see, 1 into 2 will not be equal to 2 into 2. So for such kind of circuit, we cannot eliminate this 2 ohm resistance, so the calculation will not be that much easier. So for such circuit, what should we do? I will apply a voltage of some known value, we will prefer to have V. And if this V volt is supplying some current I, then the equivalent resistance across AB can be written as V by I. Now if we can calculate the value of current for this supplied voltage, then we will get the equivalent resistance across A and B. So for the calculation of current, I will assume this point as node having potential X. This point has potential Y. Now I will apply KCL at X. Applying KCL at X, the equation can be written as, for this V battery, I will consider potential at A as V, at B it is 0. So applying KCL at X, the equations can be written as X minus V by 1 plus X minus Y by 2 plus X minus 0 by 2. From here, we will get the equation as 4X minus 2V equals to Y. This is equation number 1. Now applying KCL at Y, we will write the equation as Y minus V by 2 plus Y minus X by 2 plus Y minus 0 by 2. From this, we will get the equation 3Y minus V equal to X. Solving these two, we will get the value of X equal to 7V by 12. Very simple calculation will be there for these two linear equations. And Y will be solved to 6V by 11. Now for these two values, what happens? The current which is supplied by the battery can be calculated very easily. Because if I assume this is I1, this is I2, then whatever current is supplied by the battery will come again to the battery to close the circuit. So the I will be equal to I1 plus I2. I1 you can write X minus 0 by 2 plus Y minus 0 by 2. Putting the value of X and Y from here, we will get the current of 13V by 22. Hence, using this relation, the equivalent resistance across AB can be written as V by I, which is equal to 22 by 13 ohm. So this is a very special kind of question. Calculation will not be much tough, but we will have to take care of the steps which we need to follow. Initially, we will assume these two as a principal node. Then we will apply the KCL at this point and the KCL at this point. Remembering the concept that while applying KCL at any node, we consider that node to be at higher potential. That's why I have written, when I was writing KCL at X, I have written X minus Y by 2 for the current in this branch. But when I was writing the KCL at Y, I have written Y minus X divided by 2. Because I was considering here the Y is at higher potential in the second case and X was at higher potential in the first KCL equation. Very, very important question. Now solving for equivalent resistance for a ladder network. Ladder means a repeated network. If you see R and R, this combination is getting repeated again and again and again up to infinity. So from infinity, if we take one network out of this infinity, then the equivalent resistance will not have any effect. Now if I suppose the resistance at this point is X, the equivalent resistance at the input is X, then what happens? If I eliminate this branch, then the equivalent resistance at this point will again be X, because it is an infinite repeated network. So for this R and R, I will consider that the remaining network will be of X ohm resistance, and the resistance equivalent to its input will have value X. Now R and X is in parallel. Its equivalent will be Rx upon R plus X. This value is directly in series with R, and that will be going to equal with X. So X will be equal to R plus XR upon X plus R. If we solve this equation, then it will form X square minus XR minus R square equal to 0. Now solve for the quadratic, we will get X equal to R by 2 1 plus minus root 5. So 1 minus root 5 will result in a negative value, hence the answer can be written as, accepted answer for this question is R by 2 1 plus root 5. This is the solution for such network. Now see the next question for a ladder network only. If we have a network like this, R, 2R, then again 2R, this network is getting repeated. Then what should we do? Again, we will have to find that which combination is getting repeated. So if I redraw this circuit as this, R, R and R, from this again I have broken this 2R into R and R, connected in series, so it will again come back to 2R. So I am just rearranging the network. So if we see, this network is going to be repeated for infinite number of times. So if I consider the input resistance here as X, then the resistance at this point will also be X, because from infinity it will not affect the equivalent resistance by eliminating single branch. So I will redraw this circuit as R, R and R. This is the basic branch, and the resistance here, if it is X, then the input will also be X. Now calculating for equivalent resistance across AB, and I will equate that value with the X. So if you see R and X in series, R plus X. Here, this R plus X will be in parallel with R. So R into R plus X by 2R plus X. Now again it is in series with R. So R plus R into R plus X by 2R plus X, it will be equated to X. So we will get by cross multiplication, the equation will be 2R square plus, this is R into X plus R square plus R into X equals to, sending this to the RHS, 2RX plus X square. So 2RX and 2RX will get cancelled. From here we will be getting X square equal to 3R square. So the equivalent resistance will be written as X equals to root 3 times R, or in the option it may be given 1.73 times R. So for today's lecture I will end here only. So next, tomorrow we will start with the calculation of power, and calculation of power for the combination of bulb, and again we will be dealing with some new concept like maximum power transfer theorem. There is a theorem which guide us that how should we connect the network for having maximum power to the load. So wait for the next lecture, and till now you can solve the H.C. Verma book. I will tell you HCV, current electricity. The chapter number is actually 32. From question number 1 to, try 1 to 46. Yes. So thank you so much.